It's my birthday cake. It's chocolate and it has robots on it and silver balls like grandma's Christmas cookies.
You didn't ask for silver balls.
I added them. They're pretty.
Well, sweetheart, the cake is done.
I can get those.
Really? Promise?
Absolutely.
A real, real promise? Or when you say you promise, but then you just don't do it?
Well, award season is right around the corner, and this year you could potentially see on the Oscar nomination list a really silly and endearing short film called A Piece of Cake. And the lead actor was born right here in Toledo. So I have Rich Sommer on Zoom right now. You might have seen him in Mad Men and The Devil Wears Prada, but today we're going to talk about A Piece of Cake. So thank you so much for joining us, Rich. Why don't you go ahead and summarize for us exactly what this film is all about?
Sure. It's about a father who has been remiss in the past when tasked with fatherly duties, and decides that this one thing that his daughter wants to have these little silver balls on her birthday cake. He figures, how hard can it be? I'm going to commit, no matter what it takes, to getting this done. Little does he know, there might be a few hindrances to him getting it done.
You won't find them anywhere. They're illegal.
Why are they illegal here? Are they dangerous?
It's just in California. Martha Stewart uses them.
She went to prison.
You know, he's a regular guy. He's just a dad who wants to do better than he's been doing.
I really love what you did with that character too, because the, you know, obviously the whole premise is just, it's a little on the, you know, it's absurd, a little absurd, but you play it with such a delicate subtlety to, I think, really makes it just that much more funny. So I was wondering, you've been in a number of other big comedies. I know you had a small role in The Office. You've been in The Devil Wears Prada. Do you have a kind of comedic background? Are you drawn to that genre?
I always thought that comedy was sort of where I was going to end up. Not as a comedian. I'm terrified of stand-up comedy. But when I was in high school and into college and into graduate school and beyond, I had been studying improvisation.
It sounds a lot like improv, a lot of yes-anding.
Exactly. It was heightening. If this, then what else? If he's willing to do this, then what else is he willing to do? It's very much rooted in that.
What would you say, what advice would you give to young people, or not even young people, it's just anybody who is hoping to start a career in this industry?
It's really just about trusting your gut. That's the only true advice I can give, is to, you know, to follow your goals in this thing, but to set realistic goals and to do whatever it takes to sort of manifest those things into some sort of a reality. It doesn't mean that everybody is going to be, you know, who sets out to do it is going to be on TV or is going to be in movies or is going to be, you know, at Caroline's or wherever, you know, the end goals are. It just means that as long as those goals are realistic, each goal can be another step toward a sort of, you know, bigger goal. Again, my bigger goal being just to make my living from this thing, whatever that meant.
Now, we'll learn more about A Piece of Cake's fate with the Academy on Tuesday when the shortlist is announced, and then official nominations come mid-March. So keep your eyes peeled. I have more information on the project and on Rich's experience on our website, WTOL.com.